I think that was all of them. You want to do your thing quick, buddy, before Mama comes? Beautiful. And now I leave. Goodbye, friend. I will be back for you.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to some more Heart Arc Misadventures. And this is funny. I had started recording stuff, and I was going to do like, oh, yeah, you know, I want to go try and tame a Gigantoraptor. And I'm like, you know, I should record my first time, like, trying to do it, you know, normally. I know how to do it and everything, you know, for the most part. And the one I found died. You know, I got there as it got killed by Dimor. So it was level 12, so I was just like, yeah, you know, fine, whatever. I'll just try and find another one, and maybe we'll pick it up in the morning. And I found this one, and it's 108. So I guess we're going to be trying to tame a 108 Gigantoraptor for our first one. I am very excited about this. I really like the Gigantoraptor. I think it's going to be like a really good creature for us to have around our base, just because it does like so much for like taming and like helping tames that it's just going to be so useful overall. So, oh, bugs, hello. So now it's just going to be a case of where do we sit and where do we put our Argentavis while we sit? Because for people who don't know how you tame these things, what you have to do is throw down some fertilized eggs for them. And the bigger the egg, the longer it's going to last. So I have a handful of Argentavis eggs, which actually, I think it's still too cold. They might just start hatching. Let's drop one of the ones down that's got like a lot of time left on it. Yep, okay. Well, I guess we're gonna have to wait a little bit for that. So, alright, let's just give it a little bit and kind of just wait around and see. There is always the chance that we could make the attempt to sneak into the nest while the parent is distracted, just in general. I don't think that's a good idea for us to do, though. So, yeah, I'm just going to wait until it gets a little later on in the day for the temperature to go up. But in case we don't have enough eggs, I actually did bring the wet argent. This is my female. I did bring one of my males with me, so we can just, like, breed out some more eggs. So maybe I'll actually, like, fly over here while we're waiting and do that. That makes some sense. Let's do that while we wait. So, yeah, guys, fingers crossed we can get this here. I have high hopes. I have low expectations in myself, though, because I am known to fuck up basic things. So something as complicated as how the Gigantoraptor tame is, while straightforward, I don't have a lot of faith in myself with that. So yeah, well, ironically, random things kept happening, so we haven't even gotten one egg yet, and it's now hot enough that we actually can start this process. So I'm gonna let them lay one egg, just so we have, I think, like seven. And we'll do this. So the way this works is eggs vary from time. Like, you could use dodo eggs, but you're going to need a ton of them. I think the longest I've heard that they can stay distracted are is with, like, a fertilized giga egg. And one egg will distract them for 70 seconds. If I am remembering what I heard correct. I could be wrong. So I'm not 100% sure. I'm imagining an Argentavis egg is going to hold it for about 40 seconds. So we might be able to get two, like, shimmies in with the baby per egg. So we'll have to see. Right, let me grab that. Let's put our bird. I don't really want to, like, pick him up. Because I don't want to, like, accidentally give him cryo sickness. Because we're currently having to use PvP. Because I've been doing some breeding. Now we have to just get him to, like, find the eggs, I guess? This is where I'm, like, a little unsure. It's like, because we want to, like, stack the eggs, but we don't want to aggro the parent. So let's throw those down, and let's see what happens. There we go. Think he's interested. Yep, there he goes. Okay, so now what we can do is hop into the nest, and what we have to do from here is just wait for the baby to come over, and then we will mimic what the baby does once he comes over and starts trying to dance with us or do various things. I hope he comes over here pretty soon, because... Oh, hello. That is a flap. Okay, so it's 15%. That's actually super good, because the video I watched with this was it on 1x, and it was like 3 per. So that's super good. So I'm just going to have to keep an eye on both the parent and the child here. Because I feel like that parent is going to start moving here pretty soon. Meanwhile, the child should be coming back in for another round of play. Hello. What do you wish to do? Another flap. Flap, flap, flap. Oh, parent's done. And we bail. Ah, I'm just playing with your friend. Why? Where's my bird? Save me, bird. Hello. So, okay. 3 eggs gives us about 10%. So, that's good to know. How many more eggs do we have? We have 4. So, okay. I am going to have to breed the Argentavises a touch more. So, we'll have to do that for sure. Oh. Oh no, he's still eating. Okay, okay. Good, good. So apparently he just like gets up after a little bit. What's hitting me? Oh, hello. I thought you were still eating eggs. Why? I probably just should just like sneak around. Okay, so next time we do it, we'll do it with just 2. And we'll see how that goes. Are you still big mad at me for trying to get in the nest with the child? There's still eggs. I can still see them when we fly up. There's still 2 of them. Okay. All right, head on over to those eggs, buddy. Yeah, you want those eggs. Don't you want those eggs? They're delicious. Okay, beautiful. And now let's actually sneak in here. Yes, a little chirpy buddy. You want to come back for some more? Oh, it's actually the dodo that's chirping at me, not the baby raptor. Come on, little buddy. Okay, so that's good to know, though. Like, we got 2 with 1 egg. So, okay, we might be able to get away with, like, the Argentavis eggs that we've currently got. Hi, buddy. What you want to do? A nice little bow? This is so stinking cute. I love it so much. Alright, and he's just going to circle back around. We'll just keep an eye on big ol'... I want to say mama, but that's actually a big papa bird. Hard being a single dad out here. You know, just some fucking, like, hairless ape comes into your nest, gives you food, and then just... I think that was all of them. You want to do your thing quick, buddy, before mama comes? Beautiful. And now I leave. Goodbye, friend. I will be back for you. So, okay, so there is an animation, it looks like, for when... Oh, nope. Oh, yeah, there's an animation just flat out for when he finishes an egg. I don't know if you guys happen to catch that, but he, like, puts his... I you know, I'm doing the motion with my own head, like, I'm not fucking insane. God damn it, man. Ugh. But he, like, pops his head up a couple times, kind of like when you have something, like, delicious and your dog smells it and it's just, like, huffing. So, that's good to know. For the future. So let's head back on over there. We might be able to just drop 1 more egg actually then. Potentially. To get this. This is actually a lot easier than I was expecting it to be. I'm going to be honest. I was expecting this to be like a massive pain in the ass. And have to go through so many eggs. But we're getting this like really pretty quick. Come on back little buddy. Here he comes. He wishes to play. Hello there. Hello, friend. What do you wish to do? Ah, it's a spin. So cute. And I'm just gonna keep an eye on big ol' Papa over there. Actually, he might pop back into the nest here pretty soon. Potentially? That's the done animation that I was talking about, by the way. So let's hop over here. Hello. Do you eat the egg? Okay, we will have to drop another egg, so let's just do that now and potentially just drop them out from up here. Fly up, break some aggro. I think he's chilling. So let's give it another land. Hello. Are you not interested in those eggs that I dropped for you? I wonder if they... Well, no, they did come from my inventory, so he should be. I was going to say, sometimes... Okay, there he goes. Is he going for it? Yes, okay, cool. So that's good to note, too, that when you are flying away to, like... Or moving away to get away from the parent, you can drop more eggs out of your inventory like that. And kind of distract them. Not distract them, but get it ready for the next round of playing with the child. I also should probably drop those a little further away than I did. Hello. You coming in, buddy? Hello. Yes. What do you want to do? A nice little bow. Beautiful. So it should just be one more. I'm just going to keep an eye on Big Papa over here. Hopefully we can get this in here before he finishes up his meal and comes back on over. But my expectations are pretty low. Yep, no, because he's finishing up now. So back on our bird. Hello. And we'll just fly on up. Let him head back on over to his baby. And yeah, he did eat one egg, so... Okay. Are you still aggroed? You look like you're kind of still aggroed on me. Now you're not. Okay. I was going to say, the way he was, like, circling the ground below me was kind of just making me a little uncomfortable. Let's just get on over there for one final round of play with our new friend. I'm so excited for this, because I really... It's funny, I wasn't a big fan of the idea of the Gigantoraptor when they first announced it. Hello. Ow. Didn't you have an egg? What are you doing over here? Well, just in case, I'm gonna drop you another egg. If I can get back out of my inventory and get back over to my bird. But yeah, I wasn't a big fan of the Gigantoraptor. I was like, man, it doesn't sound exceptionally interesting to me. But like, actually seeing it and stuff, big fan. I don't know why. I think it's just because, like I've talked about a lot, I really like Terror Birds. To the point that even though I'm not a big fan of the mod itself, I actually almost put in... Okay, he's eating the egg. I thought he was coming over for me. I almost put in a prehistoric beast for the Kalinkin, which is essentially just a giant terror bird. So having these is, like, super nice. Is he eating the egg, or is he fighting something? Can't actually... I think he's fighting something, which I think is why we're not playing. He should be alright. I believe in him. He's a big... Now he's eating me! I see, it's Troodons. Okay. So that would be what was going on there. Actually, I can get involved here. So I can just pick you up and just kill you up here. I'll help you, Papa! So I can get the baby. So I can take your child home with me. Alright, I think he got them all, though. Did you get them all? Yeah. Okay, and the egg is still over there. Now, is he gonna go over for that egg, though? Or is that a little too far? That shouldn't be too far. I think he, like, initially went over there for it, and then just got, like, distracted by the Troodons. Yeah, okay, we're heading over there now, so let's head on in. Hopefully this time we can get the last one. I am getting low on Argentavis eggs. Hi, buddy. You want to properly come around there instead of, like, jittering? Or is your dad... Oh, there it is. What do you want to do? Flap. Yes! What a friendship. A beautiful friendship is formed here today. Come with me. Ugh, damn it, Helena. I don't care. I want to get him home before something happens. All right, beautiful. We got our first baby Gigantoraptor. I'm so excited. And he gets a nice egg for his trouble. Look at him. He's just like, what do I do now? I just have an egg and no child. Oh, that is a horrible looking photo. Good lord. Stat-wise, wow, that health. Wow, that's some fucking health there. 38 points into health. Wow, that's really good. Jeez. Well, alright then. I'm actually going to probably just try and grab this Argentavis egg, because it might be one of, like, my good Argentavises. I am working on, as you see, I do have a bunch of Argentavises in my inventory. And I am working on condensing them together, so it would be nice to keep some eggs, potentially. Plus, if we happen to find another... Oh, Jesus, the lag. But I can see there's already another Gigantoraptor over here. Hello. You're 40 male. Okay. Where's your child? If your child's the opposite gender, I will probably take it. It's a male. Ours is female. Sure. I was not expecting to find another one so fast, I'm gonna be honest, but I actually have cleared out a handful, so I guess that makes sense. So let's drop those eggs, and let's try and grab this male here, so we can, get some breeding going on when we, get home, because while you can't tame them, even the orphaned ones, you can breed them. Ah, he saw me. Okay. So, all right. Well, let's give this a shot, see how this goes. And, yeah, guys, I will just bring you back once we, get home, I think.
Hello, friend. What do you wish to do?
Oh, wow, this one's gonna be a lot easier. So I feel like Gilly would probably make this a lot easier, but it's definitely not needed, as you can see by the fact that I've done this twice now without it. But, I do fucking love that essentially what you're doing is just getting in the nest and pretending to be another baby. And it's just like, it's so cute. It's adorable. But, all right, I can't believe we went from none to a good one and a breeding pair. That's incredible. I can't believe it, because I think I've made a mention of it, but if we can get the saddle blueprint for it, I would love to actually use them as our boss fighting creature on this map. I think it would be a ton of fun to do. So I'm gonna fly on home, and we'll get these guys all raised up and probably breed out another male before we really do a lot, just so that way if something happens, we apparently I needed to just like be on this side of the map. This is the side that I had. That one is fucking gorgeous colors. Wow. I kind of want that child just for those color. Like, look at those. Do we want to do that? We might be able to. I think, actually, that guy didn't eat the egg. No, we'll breed our own. I think it'll... Oh, Jesus. That baby is floating in midair. But yeah, everybody, apparently I had to have just checked this side of the map because I hadn't been over here like at all. And apparently this is where they all are. So guys, I'm going to head on home and we will raise them up and probably do a bit of breeding. So we actually have a safety pair just in case something happens, because getting another one away is probably not going to happen anytime soon. And yeah, and we'll take him out and just kind of mess with him, because there's so many things that this thing does. So yeah, everybody.
Hey, there we go. It's taken a bit of breeding, but we've managed to get our own Gigantoraptor with all of the stats. They're pretty nimble as children. I'm actually very surprised by that. I'm super excited though, because we actually have a male all bred out too with all the stats. So this means that we now have a security pair, essentially, to fall back on once we actually get this one all imprinted up. So Gigantoraptors are super interesting, and a lot of their stuff starts here at the imprint stage, and I'm not 100% sure how much of them we're gonna fully make use of. I actually should equip a whatever to kind of just be ready just in case. So they get 20% with our settings, at least they get 20% per imprint, which is super nice.
But so with them, okay, hold on. So what you can do with them is they're essentially like Maywings, where you can pop them into your saddle, and as you see their juvenile Gigantoraptor is resting, it'll soon be ready to hunt level 72 plus creatures. So essentially what that means is what we can do with our Gigantoraptor is take our little Gigantoraptor out hunting, and if we kill creatures of like that kind of level, it will, as you see down there, 0 of 6, it will get a boost. And what that does is it gives it a damage dealt and damage reduction buff, as well as it applies a buff to our Gigantoraptor itself, which is a huge feature and is probably really good on servers that aren't mine, where I have like babies growing up really fast. It's something we might actually change in the future for this, because it is a substantial buff. I think like the Gigantoraptor itself can get up to a 25% bonus for stats like that. When you do the imprint like that, it's super good. So let's pick him back up for now. Let's do that. So you're also supposed to be able to interact with the baby in the saddle here. I haven't had the option to. This one looks like I might be able to. I'm not really sure. I don't know if I want to like risk it though, because I want to get 100% imprint on this, I'll be honest. But the biggest thing you can do though is you can pop them in the saddle in like a Maywing. This would count as taking them for a walk, which is super nice. And that's a huge feature. Honestly, I'm doing a really bad job exploiting the bonding feature, because it is really good. It's really strong. And honestly, if I could guarantee that we could find level 72 plus creatures, I would show it off. But I don't think we actually have. Actually, there might be an Anki back there. I know none of those Brontos are, but there might be, like, I think I had seen, like, a level 80 Anki floating around the island somewhere. But, it's something that I'll have to mess around with some more. Because if we can potentially, like, unclaim our own creatures and then kill them like that, that could work, in all honesty. Maybe we should try that out here really quick. Hang on, I think I have some spare Hyenodons. Well, actually, I wonder if the Gigantoraptor will get killed by the Hyenodon, in all honesty. I completely forgot, because I had recorded it and decided not to use it. We had an issue with the Hyenodons while I was breeding them. I had, like, gotten up for something, and they had kept breeding, and they had grown up. And I went to kill them, and they murdered Admiral. This is a different otter, unfortunately. This is not the original Admiral. They killed Admiral, they killed a baby Ceratosaurus that I'd been using to to remove children. Oh, perfect, we get to show it off here. Get in the saddle, buddy. We ride. It's beautiful. And it was so silly. It was so silly. Like, they broke my air conditioner. It just upset me a lot. But so we learned our lesson from that. I guess let's find out here, because we should be rested enough. Okay, cool. Since he's on passive, he's not going to damage us. As you can see, though, we have two different attacks, both a left click and a right click. The right click does more damage and is on, not really a cooldown at all, in all honesty. They do not count. Okay. Noted. Okay, thank you, Sauerkraut. Oh, okay, so we'll just ping if they find some Sauerkraut. He's all up in my shit. I forgot about that, too, actually. They will, when they pick a target, they'll mark it for you. So, that's a really nice feature to have. And probably better for someone, like, not me. I think I actually have some of that on me. Yeah. I was gonna say, I have a ton of cooked prime meat. Beautiful! We got 100% imprint on our raptor. Oh, look at those stats. They're so good. Like, honestly, they're really strong. Sauerkraut, stop. You're wiggling so much. Oh, gosh. So let me take that, and let's pop you into a cryo chamber, because we don't really need you anymore. You can kind of just go chill. And beautiful. One more tick, and there's our Gigantoraptor. Oh, it's glorious and beautiful. Majestic, even. We also got the white legs, which I really liked. Also, there's another feature with them where you can pluck a feather, which is, for us, once every 2 hours, but from what I've heard on official, it's once every day. And what the feather does, as you see, is it gives a percentile chance of converting a stat over, essentially. So, like, if you put it in the inventory of a mother, it will give you ours, for example, our 67, so it'll give them a 67.7% chance of passing down the higher health stat, which is really good in some situations where you want to, like... Oh, there's my Gigantoraptor. I was like, where'd my Gigantoraptor go? Where you want to just, like, do things. Give my brain a second. Where you want to, like, condense stats and you're having a hard time. Or, like, if you've done a bunch of mutations and you're trying to pass down just a single stat. Super useful. Super useful. So let's test out how good that imprint... Oh, that was a headshot. So 110 from 70. That's super nice. That's actually, like, really nice. It's 40 more damage. Damn. Also, our health... I still can't get over the health stat that we got. Fucking 38 points into health is just absolutely ridiculous. So Gigantoraptors are also a good harvester. Their stomp attack can harvest berries, and I've heard their... Okay. Their peck attack can harvest meat, and their stomp can harvest berries and wood. Well, it's supposed to harvest wood, they said, but it looks like it gets more like thatch. It's more like the Triceratops is charge. Where it's just like, oh yeah, it does this, but it's not, like, a core part of it. Also, as you see there, we have a very high jump, and we can also hold down jump and, like, flutter like a terror bird. They are just giant terror birds. I love it so much. I think I want to get your health up to 10,000, just to kind of keep him safe. And what's the other one? Okay, so we can call, and it will track... babies around the oh god, there's so many children. And that'll also, as you saw, refresh any babies that want a specific imprint. So, like, if they wanted, like, a specific kibble, we could replace that. So hello there, child. What are you? Oh, you're level 64. So the other feature with a Gigantoraptor is you're supposed to be able to imprint on babies from on top of the Gigantoraptor itself. So let's just give this parent a quick murder, because I'm not really interested in this child, but you know what, I figure it's still a good one to use to show off. So let's give you a murder here. Goodbye, friend. Oh, I'm sorry, little one. I'm sorry. So now, how do I imprint you? Okay, it's definitely not that. Oh, there it is. And there we go. And you're supposed to, if you imprint it right, you're supposed to get all of the levels, but there's a chance that we don't, because from what I've seen online, and take this with a grain of salt, as it is just the Ark Wiki that I've seen this on, it's you get amounts based on the taming effectiveness of your Gigantoraptor. So because we didn't tame this one, I think it might ping as 0-0, which means we get 0-0. On the bonuses, which is an unfortunate thing. It would have been cool, but I also kind of am fine without that, seeing as, like, I feel like taming babies is pretty cheap. I say as someone who's tamed a few babies just randomly for things, but, you know, it is a bit busted, the fact that, like, we were able just to kill a Rex and then take its child. Imagine if we were able to, like, get taming bonus on that as well. That would have been kind of silly, just for killing its parent, which was a super low level. And, like, our Rex is one of our best creatures still, even with this Gigantoraptor. So, yeah, that kind of sums up a lot of their features. I'm very interested to see how they do, though, like, out and about in the wild. I kind of want to take them out and, like, hunt and potentially do up some of the imprint stuff with them, too. I might have to mess around with my sayings, but it would be pretty funny to have a Hyenodon pack with them like this. But, yeah, everybody, I think, honestly, I'm looking at the recording timer, and I'm not 100% sure what else we can really show off with this that's gonna be, like, worth doing in the video outside of just, like, running around and hunting down creatures, which we will definitely be doing in the near future with this thing anyways, because I'm super excited to have this thing. So I think we will just wrap this up here. I'm super excited for my big, oh my god, that fucking Tokyo Drift. Also, I think we just took some fall damage. I'm super excited for my big ass bird. They look great. I'm really excited to do some color mutations too, because I've seen their regions. Their regions are really nice. So we'll have to keep our eyes peeled for any more of these and potentially try and get, if we can get a good melee stat, I think I'll be really happy, because our melee is kind of sad right now. I think we have, oh, that's an Argentavis, not a bird. That is the wrong bird. What do we even have? We have 27 points. We also have low stamina, believe it or not, at only 24. Same with weight, too. I'm not surprised with that health stat that we got. 38 is a ton of points, and probably took a lot of them from the other stats. But it's still really good. So, yeah, if we can pull a better melee, that would be nice. But honestly, we probably can make this work as it is. So, everybody, I hope you all enjoyed today's episode. And yeah, I would catch you all in the next one. Until then, peace!